So Piyush, over to you. Please come. So over to Piyush Chandak. But he was a central council. He is a regional council member representing 132,000 chartered accountants. Yes, over sir. To you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. First of all, I should like, in the morning, we were, our council colleague Shilpa, madam is also here. And in morning, we were discussing about all the curriculum and the things we take forward in an institute during those 3 years term. One thing was common in discussion was Prabhu sir's commitment towards learning. And I remember those days when I qualified as a chartered accountant in 2005, he used to conduct the courses for cooperative audits. And he used to always be the speaker over there. So for me and Shilpa madam, he is the common thread that he is our guru in that way. And the thing which I sensed yesterday also, that his passion towards this profession is still continued. He's still working so hard. He made you work hard yesterday night as well, and today also. I guess the sessions will be full of knowledge and enrichment. The only thing which I'll again appeal on behalf of our regional council of WIRC, we are always committed to take best of the programs for the development of our members and students as well. Along with the traditional practice, we are conducting various programs on the upcoming fields, and members are requested to take benefit of that, because unless we ourselves upgrade and update, we'll be extinguished sooner or later. So with this, I congratulate all of you for being part of this enriched RRC. Usually it doesn't happen like this way, but due to the efforts of Prabhu sir and the team, this is happening. And I'll wish that those RRC should be continued always, and they should be the part of our curriculum, not only once in a year or once in a while, but every 3 or 4 months, so that we will be again refreshed and energized always. With this, thank you very much for the investment.
Now we have clubbed both the session. All the speakers are here. Please come.
Just to introduce you, we have with us Advocate Nilesh Parmar. Advocate Nilesh Parmar is a practicing advocate in Cooperative Court, High Court, and specialized in the cooperative field. And recently, after doing so many service, he said, profession is good, I should continue the profession, but I also need to do some value addition to my building the asset. And now he has turned out to be a promoter also. It's an achievement. What I'm saying is, whatever you have, you are an advocate, you are something, why you cannot add something into the business? This first job, then profession, then business. Why you can't get into business? And this was in my mind also. Sir, I started with service, but I said, why not I do some business? In the year 1996, I started a housing finance company in the name of Swagat Housing Finance Company Limited. Today, it is one of the 99th housing finance company. You just Google, you will find. I am the chairman, my wife is a MD, and my son is a ED. It's a family run business. But today, it is out of 99 housing finance company across India, ours is one. Today, we are getting refinance from various institutions, including Government of India, SBI, and other banks. Coming to the point, you need to not only put your practice, the service that you get, you should do some value addition. So therefore, I wanted to project him. Secondly, whenever we are doing whatever I said just now, I'm just trying to correlate, and that is how they have become successful, and all successful guys have been brought here, professionals have been brought in. Nilesh, having seen that Dim Conveys has been started, there are so many issues which are faced, and therefore there is a Dim Conveys Practitioners Association, and he is the secretary of Dim Conveys Practitioners Association. So give him a break. So therefore, who can be the better person than him to discuss about Dim Conveys? Okay. A soft copy to hai. Aap dekho, I am not getting further. 15 chapter humne diya hai. So it will be, what we have done is we have given soft copy, we have given hard copy. So therefore, there will be direct question answer. The second, we have with us Joint Secretary of the Dim Conveys Association. Sudhir Ruya is a chartered accountant. He took up, I was architect of the Dim Conveys, but he is the one who got first Dim Conveys Ajanta Ellora Cooperative Society.
Ajanta Ellora Cooperative Society. Yeah.
Ajanta Ellora Cooperative Society in Dahisar. So he is the first person who got deemed convinced. Now, before he could get the order, there were a lot of hackles, issues. And like, sir, आपने डीम कन्विंस बुक लिखा है, आपने डीम कन्विंस का ये किया, वो किया, राष्ट्रपति भवन में भी जाके आए, अभी मुझे बताओ ये कैसा करना है. सो यू टेल मी वेदर आई गाइडेड यू, नॉट गाइडेड यू, हाउ यू कुड अचीव दैट फर्स्ट अचीवमेंट, कैन यू जस्ट शेयर.
सर, ही इज माई मेंटर, ही डिड द होल थिंग. वो बोलते हैं ना, खाता कोई और है और क्रेडिट कोई और लिख के जाता है, वो वाली बात हो गई. आई गॉट दैट case I have represented, but before making representation to the authority, I went to him. मैंने कहा भाई मैंने पहला केस लिया है, this is my beginning. तो he guided me how to go about it. I submitted the application before the authority. Gorpade saab was the, I think, the first DDR that time. And once I submitted, of course with his assistance, he called me on phone after the file was put up. गोलपरे साहब ने मुझे फोन किया, लोहिया जी जरा आके मिलिए मुझे. आई वेंट टू हिम, सेड द एप्लीकेशन इज सो वेल प्रिपेयर्ड, इट इज सो नाइसली प्रिपेयर्ड, ये अगर कोई बहुत ज्यादा इसमें ऑब्जेक्शंस नहीं आते हैं तो दिस विल बी आवर फर्स्ट डीम कन्वेंस ऑफ द, विल स्टार्ट विद दिस फर्स्ट कन्वेंस.
सो ही गॉट द फर्स्ट डीम कन्वेंस. नाउ ही इज अ जॉइंट सेक्रेटरी ऑफ द एसोसिएशन. जिस सर से देखो, हम लोग दूसरे को फॉलो करते हैं. जिस सर से परमार जी ने बिल्डर बन गया, वो कैसा बना मालूम है? उनका गुरु था सुधीर लोहिया जी, वो पहला बिल्डर बन गए. तो वो भी प्रमोटर है अभी, यस और नो?
आई वाज प्रमोटर सिंस लॉन्ग बैक.
अच्छा.
आई डिड द कपल ऑफ बिल्डिंग्स, बट देन द डीम कन्वेंस में लाने के लिए आप ही जिम्मेदार हैं.
मतलब बिल्डर से आपको डीम कन्वेंस?
यस, दैट वाज द अदर वे.
अच्छा अच्छा. एनीहाउ, सो हिज सन इज ऑल्सो फुल टाइम बिल्डर. सो वी हैव जॉइंट सेक्रेटरी हियर सुधीर लोहिया, विल डिस्कस ऑन द डीम कन्वेंस. Then we have Kirti Nagda, advocate. He is famous in the property related matter, cooperative law, membership, appeal, cooperative court, and he has a team of more than 15-20 advocates and well practicing. But we respect each other so much. Then advocate Naresh Pai is more into stamp duty registration, amnesty scheme 2008 ka jab se amnesty scheme aaya, पूरा का पूरा एमएनसी स्कीम का, स्टैम्प ड्यूटी का, रजिस्ट्रेशन का, तो पूरा का उन्होंने रिलीज इट, अदर थिंग्स डॉक्यूमेंट्स ही डज, एंड ही आल्सो अपीयरिंग इन द कोपरी कोर्ट, हाई कोर्ट्स. एंड देन वी हैव विजय, सीए विजय जोशी, हु इज अगेन यू नो चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट बट प्रैक्टिसिंग इन कोऑपरेटिव लॉ एज वेल एज एनजीओस, एनपीओस, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ट्रस्ट, कॉम्प्लायंसेस. देन एडवोकेट किरण, सी इज in her initial career she joined of course our office, and since then she is associated with Naresh Pai, and now she is appearing for deemed convinced writ petition before the honorable high court. And what happened was, just to tell you the story, the DDR did not allow the landowner to be a party to the convinced application. They are intervened in the deemed convinced application saying that we are the co-owners and we are the landowners, so please make us a party. We made a submission, DDR refused. Now this will become a case law. DDR refused, rejected. Of course, the conveyance was already in the name of builder. Builder had a property card in his name. However, there was a dispute within the family. So the one family co-owner was disputing with another co-owner. I said, abhi high court mein gaya hai na, law of nature is follow nahi hua hai, it will be remanded. I convinced the society, I convinced the DDR, saying that let it come back. ये तो छोड़ने को तैयार नहीं है. एडवोकेट है ना, वो बोलते हैं मैं सर, मैं ऐसे नहीं से छोड़ेगी नहीं, मैं कैसे भी करके उसको हमारा DDR का ऑर्डर हम कन्फर्म कराएंगे. बिलीव मी, शी पुट ऑल द एफर्ट्स, 2-3 days, डिड सो मच केस स्टडी, मेट 3-4 काउंसिल, एंड अल्टीमेटली that counsel and she could manage, or I would say could convince the judge, not confuse the judge, and they got the order saying that the deemed conveyance has been properly done, and if you have any grievances you should better go to city civil court, and writ petition will not come. So that way she got the order confirmed. So give her a round of applause. Bolake maine
इतना एक्साइटेड थी उधर कोर्ट से मेरे को फोन कर रहे हैं, मतलब आ जाओ अपन डिस्कस करेंगे. सो डीम कन्विंस देर इज ए सर्कुलर ऑफ 22 जून 2018 सीरियल नंबर 15 लास्ट आइटम. सो इफ यू रियली वॉन्ट टू प्रैक्टिस डीम कन्विंस दिस मच इज इनफ. ओके यू स्टडी दिस ऑल द फॉर्मेट्स आर देयर, प्रोसीजर्स आर देयर. स्टैम्प ड्यूटी का सर्कुलर है 12 दैट इज सीरियल नंबर जो है 14 दैट इज इन पेज नंबर. सो इफ यू रीड दिस टू सर्कुलर्स इट इज इनफ. नाउ जस्ट लुक एट पेज नंबर 35. कैन यू गो टू पेज नंबर 35? इन माय ऑफिस वी हैव ए सिस्टम. एनी डीम कन्वेज वी डू बिफोर इट इज सबमिटेड टू द रजिस्ट्रार वी डू द स्क्रूटनी. Scrutiny of application for deemed conveyance. There are about 55, 56, 57, 58 jo scrutiny hai. When the application is ready, the another person will do the scrutiny, so that if the scrutiny mein koi defects hai, we are able to rectify it in advance. So this is how a procedure scrutiny ka diya hai, page number 35 se leke page number 39. So this will help you. And various formats are given. I would request you to go through in properly, so that if you do this, this is very good practice. The second session is session 8. For session 8, both all are cooperative law advocates and they know. Therefore, we have merged the session number 8. That is again registration and management of cooperative society. If you look at the content, there is a cooperative society management. Kya hai? Types of housing societies. Registration of housing societies, then silent features, model bylaws of housing society, then election to the managing committee affairs and responsibility of the committee, various things we are given, maintenance of books of accounts, statutory action which can be taken, and what are the violations which can be committed, and obligations of the members, problems in housing society, how it can be redressed with the different authorities, funds and its utilization, audit of housing societies. So there are about 13 chapters. One is 15 chapter, another 13 chapter. Both the notes are available with you. They're all very simple. If you really apply your mind, I think it can be done. Team 8 and team 9, just raise your hand. Okay, I'll start with the first question to Nilesh Bhai. There's a misconception that deemed conveyance is not a conveyance. It does not give you FSI, it does not give you TDR. You are not able to get any benefit and it's time consuming. And therefore, can you say what is the difference between a conveyance and deemed conveyance and whether they are able to get the benefit of FSI, TDR, redevelopment and all?
Good morning to all. It is a very good question. Ye hum log jitni bhi society mein jaate hai, to last क्वेश्चन जो आता है वो हम लोग को सर ने पहले पूछ लिया. कन्वेंस, कन्वेंस मीन्स द लीगल ट्रांसफर ऑफ द लैंड अलोंग विद द बिल्डिंग टू द सोसाइटी एंड इट शुड बी द स्टैट्यूटरी ऑब्लिगेशन अंडर मोफा एक्ट दैट प्रमोटर हैज टू कन्वे लैंड अलोंग विद द बिल्डिंग विद इन अ 4 मंथ फ्रॉम द डेट ऑफ रजिस्ट्रेशन. दो बिल्डर अगर करके देता है तो हमारा कन्वेंस गिफ्ट का ड्राफ्ट बनता है, उस पर स्टैम्प ड्यूटी भर के रजिस्ट्रेशन, दैट इज कॉल्ड अ डायरेक्ट कन्वेंस. और सेकेंड, अगर डायरेक्ट कन्वेंस नहीं देते हैं तो वी हैव टू ऑप्शन प्रायर टू डीम कन्वेंस, दैट सिटी सिविल कोर्ट, कंज्यूमर कोर्ट. वी अप्रोच द सिटी सिविल कोर्ट, कंज्यूमर कोर्ट टू गेट अवर कन्वेंस इन फेवर ऑफ द सोसाइटी. इट विल टेक वेरी लेंथी प्रोसीजर, इट विल टेक मोर देन मैक्सिमम इज 12 ईयर्स. तो जो भी सोसाइटी जाती है तो वेरी लेंथी प्रोसीजर थी और उसमें कन्वेंस मिलना बहुत मुश्किल है, बिकॉज दैट कोर्ट इज ओनली डायरेक्टिव पावर. दे कैन गिवन ओनली डिरेक्शन टू द प्रमोटर टू कन्वे विद इन 6 मंथ फ्रॉम द डेट ऑफ ऑर्डर. अगर वो नहीं करता है देन अगेन वी हैव टू गो फॉर एग्जीक्यूशन. तो ये बहुत डिले प्रोसीजर थी. डीम कन्वेंस, डीम कन्वेंस इट इज अ बाई वे ऑफ अमेंडमेंट इन द मोफा एक्ट. वॉट इज द स्टेच्यूटरी ऑब्लिगेशन कास्ट ऑन द प्रमोटर टू कन्वे द प्रॉपर्टी विद इन 4 मंथ फ्रॉम द डेट ऑफ रजिस्ट्रेशन, दैट टू कवर बाय द गवर्नमेंट. And for that, government has empowered DDR, District Deputy Registrar, to give a conveyance to the society. So whatever conveyance given by the government, that is called a deemed conveyance. And why word use dimmed? Because you are the owner, you are the deemed owner of your land along with the building from the expiry of 4 months of registration of society. So you are the deemed owner there. That's why they use the word deemed conveyance. Because you are deemed owner, therefore you, that is called a deemed conveyance. तो ये गवर्नमेंट जो देती है उसको डिम्ड कन्वेंस बोलते हैं, उसके लिए उनके जो प्रोसीजर और देती है। तो सबसे पहले तो हम जो भी सोसाइटी में जाते हैं ये पूरा हम बताते हैं, उनको प्रेजेंटेशन देता हाउ वी गो टू फॉर डिम्ड कन्वेंस, कैसे प्रोसीजर हो, क्या होगा। तो लास्ट में कोई एकाध दो मेंबर उठ के सेम क्वेश्चन पूछता है, जैसे सर ने अभी पूछ लिया, सर डिम्ड कन्वेंस तो हमारा हो जाएगा, कन्वेंस कब होगा? डिम्ड कन्वेंस तो हो जाएगा, कन्वेंस कब हो जाएगा? और दूसरा मिसकंसेप्शन यही चल रहा है कि डीम कन्वेंस के बाद हम रीडेवलपमेंट में नहीं जा सकते, दैट इज वेरी रॉन्ग। डीम्ड कन्वेंस इज बेटर देन द कन्वेंस बिकॉज इट इज अ गिवन बाय द गवर्नमेंट आफ्टर डूइंग ऑल ड्यू डिलीजेंस। डीम कन्वेंस का प्रोविजन लाने का जो कॉन्सेप्ट था उसका रीजन ये था, और उसका बर्थ प्लेस था बोरीवली लक्ष्मी छाया बिल्डिंग। लक्ष्मी छाया बिल्डिंग कॉलेप्स इन 2005। 15 दिन के बाद ऑल मेंबर गैदर्ड और उन्होंने ब्लूप्रिंट लेके आया और एक कॉन्ट्रैक्टर को बुलाया कि हमारी जैसी बिल्डिंग है सेम टू सेम बना दो। तब जाके उनको मालूम पड़ेगा दे नॉट आर द ओनर ऑफ द लैंड, देयरफॉर दैट नॉट एंटाइल्ड फॉर द एनी FSI TDR और कंस्ट्रक्ट द बिल्डिंग। तब जाके ये ड्राइव चला रमेश प्रभु जी ने इतनी ये, और जो डीम कन्वेंस का अमेंडमेंट होकर प्रोविजन आया। और डीम कन्वेंस लाने का दूसरा रीजन ये भी था क्योंकि बहुत सारी बिल्डिंग बहुत जूनी हो चुकी है, 40 years ओल्ड है। तो इफ़ यू आई वॉन्ट टू फाइल अ केस ऑन माई प्रमोटर, तो प्रमोटर कहाँ है मुझे नहीं मालूम, कंपनी है नहीं है, डिजोल्व हो चुकी है, लैंड ओनर कौन है, लैंड ओनर जिंदा है मर गया है, तो उसके लिए इट इज़ वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड थिंग टू गेट अ कन्वेंस। तो डीम कन्वेंस इट इज़ वेरी इजी प्रोसीजर टू गेट द कन्वेंस फेवर ऑफ द सोसाइटी। तो माई आंसर इज दैट the conveyance should be better is deemed conveyance, it is given by government after due diligence, or deemed conveyance lene ke baad aap redevelopment mein ja sakte ho, TDR FSI everything you will get। to ye deemed conveyance ho ya conveyance ho, all FSI TDR benefit will you will get। aur bahut sari building deemed conveyance hone ke baad रीडेवलप हो चुके हैं, जैसे कि लोया सर ने भी 2 साल बिल्डिंग की है, और मेरी जो फर्स्ट एज अ प्रमोटर मैंने बिल्डिंग है उसका डीम कन्वेंस में खुद लाया था और वो रीडेवलप करके उनको मैंने पजेशन दे चुका हूँ।
ओके, सो इन शॉर्ट कन्वेंस इज द ऑब्लिगेशन ऑफ ट्रांसफरिंग द लैंड एंड बिल्डिंग बाय द प्रमोटर इन द नेम ऑफ द सोसाइटी। इट्स द ड्यूटी ऑफ द सोसाइटी एज पर बायलॉ नंबर 5A टू ऑब्टेन द कन्वेंस ऑफ लैंड एंड बिल्डिंग, एंड दिस इज द वेरी पर्पस ऑफ द सोसाइटी। And therefore, the deemed conveyance is one of the legal remedy which is available in the provisions of MOFA under Section 11, saying that if the builder does not convey the land and building within 4 months from the date of formation of society, there you may, for the required grievances, redressal or remedial measure, you can approach the competent authority, that is none other than the district deputy registrar, and get the conveyance of land and building in your name as deemed conveyance, and the district deputy registrar will step into the shoes of the landowner and builder by carrying out the due process of law, as he has rightly pointed out, by giving a show cause notice, by inviting, giving them a hearing, and entire process is completed. Thereafter, the appropriate order will be passed, and once the order is passed, DDR will step into the shoes of the builder, he will step into the shoes of the landowner, and as per the delegations of the power given by the government of Maharashtra, as Nilesh ji has rightly pointed out, on behalf of the government the conveyance is given to you. So therefore the government has empowered the defaulting, or rather DDR as a competent authority, to step into the shoes of defaulting promoters and convey the land and building, and therefore you get the title of the land as required under the Transfer of Property Act, as required under the Registration Act to register the property, and as required under the Stamp Act you will pay the stamp duty, and as required in the Maharashtra Land Record your name will appear in the Satbara or the property card, and you become the effective legal owner. Having become an effective legal owner, naturally you will have all the entitlement of the owner of the land, that is go for redevelopment, take FSI, TDR, everything. So this is a remedial measure when the builder does not give the conveyance. Thank you very much. Yes, Vijay ji.
If you look at the history, historically for years together, Transfer Property Act always acted as the basis for transfer of title. And Transfer Property Act said that there has to be, as the contract is, there has to be a transfer of title coupled with possession. Now, this transfer of title would be complete only when the execution is, the deed of conveyance is executed, right? But all the other things were completed when the due process of construction was completed. So what happened was that the flat owner paid money through builder, got the possession, everything was over. Only thing that was remaining was the documentary conveyance. And for this conveyance, builder's lobby, promoter's lobby, builders played on the law, on the lacunas of law, deficiencies of implementation of various authorities in various places. And therefore, they prevented conveyance by keeping that authority in their hands under the power of attorney and the agreement, and utilize it to their benefit by claiming additional FSI and whatever floating FSI, that was the concept then. And then this exploitation led to such situations where the society, the owners and the society members did not know anything. That is where this concept came in, which actually took the entire procedure of whatever is the process. See, all the processes of giving the advertisement, verifying the title, all these are taken care of and deemed conveyance. And all those authority, because who is the authority? There are two authorities. One is the court. Court says that these are the procedures of law which are implemented in terms of law. And the government has come out with the making of law where MOFA is amended and this deemed conveyance procedure is elaborated. So once this elaborated procedure is followed, deemed conveyance becomes conveyance. So there is no separate conveyance required. That is what
आज हम बॉम्बे में इतना ज्यादा रीडेवलपमेंट देख रहे हैं. आई थिंक एवरी सेवेंथ एट बिल्डिंग इन अ रो इज गेटिंग रीडेवलप्ड. इन फैक्ट दैट इज ओनली हैपनिंग बिकॉज ऑफ द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ डीम कन्वेंस, बिकॉज डीम कन्वेंस इज इन प्लेस. अगर ये डीम कन्वेंस लॉ नहीं होता था तो आज के तारीख में बिल्डर्स यूज टू एक्सप्लॉइट, वो देते नहीं थे कन्वेंस. दे यूज टू चार्ज करोड़ ऑफ रुपीज टू गेट द कन्वेंस एग्जीक्यूटेड इन फेवर ऑफ द सोसाइटीज. But having got this deemed conveyance, आज easily, for example, नीलेश भाई ने 250-300 conveyance किए, मैंने 250-300 किए, सर ने तो 1000 के ऊपर किए होंगे. All these deemed conveyances होने के बाद these societies are coming for redevelopment, and what that scenario that we are seeing in Bombay is all because of deemed conveyance having got with the societies.
Thank you. Yeah, yeah. All have the liberty to express.
I would like to add to this. If the advantage for getting the deemed conveyance, one more advantage is that the mutation of the revenue record. Because what happens that if you go to enter your name into the property card, in a regular conveyance what happens is that the entire hierarchy is required to be maintained over there. That the Mr. So-and-so, thereafter whoever names are coming, so you will have to give all evidences over there. But once you get the deemed conveyance, the government has created your title, so straight away the name of the society would appear on the mutation. The name of the society will be mutated on the property card. And once the property card is there, so you become a legal owner in the government record, because the revenue record also gets transferred because of the deemed conveyance. And thereafter that you can go for the development or the redevelopment. So the mutation also is one of the important part, where otherwise also you had a lot of issues. Secondly, sometimes it is seen that in the regular conveyance also there appears to be mistakes. Mistakes in the area, mistakes in writing the CTF number or cadastral survey number, which also can be cured by getting a deemed conveyance, wherein you can mention proper area, you can mention your proper CTF number and get your revenue record mutated in your name, and thereafter redevelopment can happen. So this is also one of the advantages.
Yeah, thank you. We have with us Advocate Naresh Pai. Advocate Naresh Pai ji, yeah, you can ask the question.
In case of leasehold, the lease agreement was signed, but lease deed has not been signed. So can the deemed conveyance be obtained in that matter also?
हो सकता है. आप lease conveyance के लिए application कर सकते हैं और lease conveyance grant हो सकता है. I mean होगा. लीज असाइनमेंट होगा, लीज डीड बनेगा,
रिमेनिंग
पीरियड के
लीज एग्रीमेंट वॉज डन, लीज डीड हैज नॉट बीन एग्जीक्यूटेड.
या डीड ऑफ असाइनमेंट होगा, आप डीम्ड कन्वेंस में जा सकते हो. जो डीम्ड कन्वेंस का प्रोसीजर के मुताबिक 6 महीना या 3 महीने के अंदर ऑर्डर पास होगा, चांस ऑफ हियरिंग दिया जाएगा लैंड ओनर बिल्डर्स को, एंड ऑर्डर विल बी पास्ड. एंड एक बार ऑर्डर पास हो गया, आप बाकी का डीड ऑफ असाइनमेंट बना के उसका स्टैम्प ड्यूटी भर के रजिस्ट्रेशन करके आप अपना लीज कन्वेंस प्राप्त कर सकते हो.
ओके, सो इन दैट केस द डीम्ड कन्वेंस लाइक द लीज कन्वेंस.
यस,
थैंक यू.
डीम्ड कन्वेंस ही है ये, बट लीज कन्वेंस बोलते हैं उसको.
ओके,
क्योंकि आपको लीज देना देने का.
आई नीड टू जस्ट एक्सप्लेन हियर. सी द टाइटल ऑफ द लैंड, जरा समझने का कोशिश करिए. द टाइटल ऑफ द लैंड हैज गॉट टू डिफरेंट राइट्स. द वन इज फ्रीहोल्ड राइट्स, अनदर इज ए लीजहोल्ड राइट्स. द फ्रीहोल्ड राइट्स व्हेन यू गिव दैट इज कॉल्ड कन्वेंस डीड, एंड व्हेन यू गिव लीज राइट इट इज कॉल्ड लीज डीड. ओके, और डीड ऑफ लीज डीड और असाइनमेंट ऑफ लीज एंड ऑल. नाउ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय कन्वेंस? आप लोग, निखिल भाई, बहुत बार हम लोग बोलते हैं आप मुझे कन्वेंस दोगे ना, आने जाने का भाड़ा. कन्वेंस मतलब ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय ट्रांसपोर्टेशन एक्सपेंसेस और ट्रैवलिंग एक्सपेंसेस? व्हिच मींस मूविंग फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस. दैट मींस ट्रांसफरिंग फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस. सो कन्वेंस मींस ट्रांसफर, मूवमेंट. नाउ इन कर्स, इन द केस ऑफ ए लैंड टाइटल, the conveyance means we always write sale deed, transfer deed, conveyance deed, which means from the original owner the title is moving to the, now also there is a movement happening to the new person. So therefore now the question is, if in the MOFA agreement, Maharashtra ownership flat agreement or agreement for sale, if it is written that the builder and the landowner will give you a lease, then you will get a lease conveyance. If your agreement for sale says you will get a ownership of the title, freehold title, then you will get a freehold title. The deemed conveyance is a process in which builder does not give a lease right, go for deemed conveyance of lease. If the builder does not give a ownership of the title, go to the DDR and get the ownership of the title. The DDR is not supposed to give a better title than what has been mentioned in the MOFA agreement. If the Maharashtra ownership flat agreement says, agreement for sale says, the builder will give you a lease, then the DDR also has to give a lease. Are you with me? Clear?
I would just give here one poser, or the even the panelist members also here, that the presuming that the builder have the builder have got the ownership right, that means he have, he has a freehold right. But in the MOFA agreement, he writes that the I will be giving a lease to you. I am not going to give you a freehold right. So while selling the flat, he puts a condition that the ultimately I will be giving you a leasehold right, keeping freehold rights with me.
Okay, now Nilesh bhai, aapke liye.
Mera ek matter mein ho chuka hai sir.
Haan, very good.
Landowner has formed the partnership firm. Partnership firm banane ke baad, उन्होंने पार्टनरशिप फॉर्म में ये बिल्डिंग बनाया है और उसने उसमें एक क्लोज डाला है मोफा में कि आफ्टर फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सोसाइटी दे गेव अ लीज. तो यहाँ पर टाइटल जब भी देखो, जो भी जूनियर है, जो भी सीखते, तो अपने को मेन मोफा का जो एग्रीमेंट है उसको पूरा पढ़ना है, उसमें जो है टाइटल कैसे डिराइव हो रहा है वो देखना है. तो मैंने उसमें एक चीज़ देखा कि लीज दिया जाएगा, उसमें लिखा गया था ओनर इज अ फॉर्म द पार्टनरशिप फॉर्म. There is no any lease deed from the owner to that partnership firm. तो यहाँ पर lease deed नहीं है, तो owner ही खुद है, उन्होंने ही partnership firm बनाया. Means the title goes from the owner to the partnership firm is the ownership title. तो सिर्फ lease लिखने से नहीं चलता है. तो बहुत सारे high court के judgment है, उसमें लिखा है कि whatever written इन द MOFA एग्रीमेंट इट शुड बी एज पर द मॉडल 5. अगर उसके हिसाब से अगर कोई क्लोज नहीं है, दैट इज ट्रीटेड इज इनवैलिड क्लोज और उसको इंटरप्रेट नहीं किया जाता है. तो हमने बोला कि भाई हमको तो डीम कन्वेंस ही चाहिए, पर DDR ने ऑर्डर पास कर दिया लीज का, बता कि नो आई कैन नॉट ट्रेवल बिहाइंड द
MOFA agreement, because there is also various judgments stating that DDR has to through go through the MOFA agreement only, step into the shoes of the promoter, उनकी जो liability वो देना है. तो यहाँ मेरे केस में मैंने उसे ऑलरेडी पिटीशन फाइल कर चुकी है, पिटीशन ऑन बोर्ड है, तो 101% तो वो फेवर में ही आएगा रिटर्न बैक करने के बाद. तो ये जो लिखा है वो देखना चाहिए. अभी एक मैं दूसरी सोसाइटी कर रहा हूँ, उसमें दोनों टाइटल है. मीन्स लैंड ओनर वन ट्रस्ट, ही इज गिवन अ लीज टू द थर्ड पर्सन, दैट थर्ड पर्सन गिवन अ डेवलपमेंट राइट टू द डेवलपर प्रमोटर. तो लीज राइट उनको दिया है, लीज राइट से उनको डेवलपमेंट राइट दिए गए हैं. तो प्रॉपर्टी कार्ड में लैंडलॉर्ड का भी नाम है, लेजी का भी नाम है. ऑन अदर साइड लैंडलॉर्ड ऑल्सो गिवन अ डेवलपमेंट राइट टू मी. तो 50% प्रॉपर्टी लीज पे उनको दी गई थी, मुझे पूरा 100% प्रॉपर्टी का कन्विंस ओनरशिप का डेवलपमेंट राइट किया हुआ है. तो मैं अभी जो डीम कन्विंस की एप्लीकेशन करने वाला, देयर आई एम आस्किंग प्रेयर फॉर बोथ द थिंग. आई गॉट द लीज असाइनमेंट ऑफ दैट 50% एंड द एंटायर प्लॉट का कन्विंस भी चाहिए. तो जब मैं प्रॉपर्टी कार्ड में नाम चढ़ाने जाऊंगा तो लैंडलॉर्ड का नाम भी स्ट्राइक आउट हो जाएगा, लेजी का नाम भी स्ट्राइक आउट हो जाएगा, और एक ही ऑर्डर में दोनों का डीड भी वैसे ही ड्राफ्ट करनी पड़ेगी, डीम कन्वेंस कम डीड ऑफ लीज ऑफ असाइनमेंट. तो ये जो भी रहता है, जो इतना भी है, सब MOFA एग्रीमेंट आपको ध्यान से पढ़ना है, और MOFA एग्रीमेंट में जो लिखा है उसके हिसाब से ही कन्वेंस डीड के लिए अप्लीकेशन करनी है. तो MOFA एग्रीमेंट इज द बेस ऑफ योर डीम कन्वेंस. तो जो भी उसके हिसाब से
थैंक यू कीर्ति नगला, यू सर यू रेज द क्वेश्चन, नाउ आंसर इट ऑल्सो.
सर माई व्यू इज दिस दैट द DDR steps in the shoes of promoter, and if the promoter has got the right, has a freehold right, the DDR when he steps in the shoes of the promoter, he has to give the freehold right conveyance, not the leasehold right. Even though it is mentioned in the MOFA agreement that he will be giving a leasehold right, but since the promoter has got the right of freehold, the DDR has to pass an order that the freehold conveyance has to be given.
Very good.
Can I?
Sir, you are a joint secretary.
Two things are very important.
Joint secretary.
There are two important aspects in this whole issue. One is Section 11 of MOFA, which deals with the conveyance. It very clearly states all the right title interest of the promoter has to be transferred to the association of the flat buyers.
That's correct.
All word is very important here. Now, if you have made a clause in the flat purchase agreement stating that only lease will be granted, whereas the promoter is actually holding the entire rights of the whole freehold proper rights, then that becomes inconsistent with the statute provisions. What has to be put in the agreement has to be consistent, that contracts has to be consistent with the statutory provisions. So such provision will not be accepted, and that having been inconsistent with the law, such a clause in the flat purchase agreement becomes invalid, and therefore the entire freehold conveyance has to be given. Okay. That is one thing, sir. Yeah. Another very important aspect, recently Ankit Lohia, my brother's son, he has argued the same matter in High Court, and he has won this matter, stating that because law provides for transfer of all the rights, this clause of lease cannot be accepted. Another thing, sir, which is again one you all have to understand, supposing the landlord, who is the owner, passes on only the lease rights to the developer, and then developer puts an agreement, a clause in the flat purchase agreement that I'll be giving the lease. In such case, yes, only lease can be transferred. The reason being, the developer only has limitation, he only has lease rights. So that's all that he has, so all that has to be transferred. He cannot give a better title.
Okay, done. Excellent. Now go to Advocate Kiran. Can you explain from the start till the registration and obtaining a property card, what is the procedure? See, ultimately, deemed conveyance or conveyance means your name should appear in the government record. In order to appear in the government record, builder is not doing, we are going for deemed conveyance. So give us the entire process and how it can be done.
See, as very well explained by all the dignitaries over here, the first thing is conveyance. So either you go for a regular conveyance or you go for a deemed conveyance. This is the first call which the general body has to take. Now, how do you take this call? First, when your society is formed, the first objective of a society is to get the land and the building conveyed in the name of the society. So the first step, the first initial beginning which a society is going to start with is whether to check that the promoter is ready to give the conveyance in the name of the society. Now, in case there are developers who give the conveyance to the society, they don't keep the rights with them. So if the society is that lucky that they get such a promoter who are ready to relinquish all their rights and give it to the society without keeping any undue advantage with them, like any benefit clause of FSI, TDR, or any such thing, in that case, yes, society shall go with the developer. So that is a first call. That is called as regular conveyance. Regular conveyance means where the vendors and the purchaser come together and get a document executed. That is called deed of conveyance. So in that case, society don't have to approach before a competent authority, and it is as simple as that. Now here also the processes are the same. The first process in regular conveyance is you approach a developer, the developer executes a deed of conveyance for you, you get it registered before the authority by paying the stamp duty. Even here and even in deemed conveyance, the next call is you have to pay the stamp duty. Once the stamp duty is paid, only then the deed of conveyance gets registered. Thereafter, once the stamp duty is paid, then the next process is getting the mutation entry recorded in the property card. Now, when you go for a regular conveyance, so this is what I'm talking about, regular conveyance. So the protocols which society has to take while executing a regular conveyance is whether there are any silent clauses in the deed of conveyance. When I say silent clauses, it means whether the developer has kept any FSI and TDR benefit with him. Does he has any future benefit in that land? So those things has to be checked. In case the developer is ready to give you the conveyance, but there are certain conditions that the future development will go to him, any benefit of FSI and TDR will belong to him. In that case, the society has a right to take a call of deemed conveyance in its general body. So these are the two things. The first is regular conveyance. In case the developer is ready to give the conveyance to the society without any terms and conditions. So in that case, society can very well execute the deed of conveyance, pay the stamp duty, get it registered, and then go for the mutation entry. The second we call is deemed conveyance, on which we had a discussion currently. Now, what is a deemed conveyance? The rest of the procedures, I mean the execution, registration, name change, are all same, like the one for regular conveyance. The only additional process here which is added is before the procedure, before the competent authority. Now, when the society is not getting a conveyance within a period of 4 months after its registration, the society is left with the option to go for a deemed conveyance. It means you already have become an owner as per the procedure of law. But there has to be someone who will certify what area are you supposed to get in the deemed conveyance, what is the title, the discussion right now which we had. That is the scope which the DDR has to decide. The scope is what area are you entitled for. Second is which title are you entitled for, whether it is a freehold title or whether it is a leasehold title. With these two questions, the society has to go before a competent authority which is established under the provisions of Maharashtra Ownership of Flats Act 1963. Prior to this act, what society was left with an option is to go before a citizen-civil court, to go before a consumer court, or before a criminal court. Now when we say court, you all know court means a pure litigation. So when we go with a litigation for conveyance before any court, the minimum period which we spend is 10, 12, 15 years. And in case of a society, the members are not permanent, the office bearers are not permanent, the committee is not permanent. So there are no one to proactively initiate the process for 10 to 12 years. So that was the reason why the conveyance was stuck in all the housing societies. Taking all these things in mind, the MOFA Act has been amended by incorporating a section called Section 5A, where a separate competent authority is been set up who can look after the conveyance process in a society and help the societies to get the conveyance as fast as within a period of 6 months. So this is the new amendment which has taken place. When I say a court, the thing which comes in my mind is that I have to step in the court and waste my 10 to 15 years. And when I say before a competent authority, the remedy which I get, the certificate which I get through an authority is within a period of 6 months from the date I make an application. And that is much a simple process. There are no cross-examinations take place, no examination chief. It is just a summary proceeding before an authority. So what I have to do? The first thing is the society has to check whether the promoters are ready or they are not ready. If they are ready without any adverse terms and conditions, yes, you can go for a regular conveyance. In case they are not ready and the process is getting dragged, and due to which you think that the developer can use the benefit and construct additional building, so you can immediately take a call and go for deemed conveyance. Now, while going for deemed conveyance, the first thing is the general body has to pass a resolution that yes, we are ready to go for the deemed conveyance. Then you can file a deemed conveyance application before the competent authority, and as per the GR which has been stated, the Prabhu sir which has referred a GR, so that is of 22nd June 2018. That is a complete guidelines issued by the corporate department on how the deemed conveyance should be with respect to all the four processes. Before the competent authority, how it should be before the registrar who will be registering the deed of conveyance, and how the mutation entries will be taking place, and also about the stamp duty. So that is the guidelines for conveyance. So the first process is deemed conveyance before the competent authority. There you have to make an application under section 11 of MOFA, as per form number 7. So that is a prescribed form, but that is a simple form. We have to put up our inputs in that. The basic thing for conveyance is first you have to check what is the area entitlement the society should get. Because just picking on conveyance won't fulfill your obligations. The first thing is what area the society should get and what title the society should get. But obviously for that you have to go as per the MOFA agreement, the previous title documents, as well as the building plans. Now when society takes up a call that yes, we want to go for the deemed conveyance, then as a consultant our first work should be what are the documents required, whether the society has all those sufficient documents with them. The major documents which are required is the MOFA agreement which the developer executes with the flat purchaser, because that document will give you the brief about the complete title of land. Also the size of the layout or size of a single land on which the building is constructed. Thereafter we require the building plans, because that will show you the history of that building. What was the land, what FSI has been consumed, whether there is a balance FSI on the land, whether the layout development, whether the single building constructed. So all these things, all the answers to these questions you can derive only from the building plans. A title search will be required to see whether there are any encumbrances on that particular land, whether any third party rights have been created by the developer. So whether there is an occupation certificate. Previous to 2017, the deemed conveyance was difficult for the societies because there was no occupation certificate. So now even the authority, the co-opted department has reduced that burden. So even now the societies in Mumbai who do not have an occupation certificate can also go for the deemed conveyance. So these are the documents which are required, basically the registration certificate of society, the plan and all those things. Along with that, to certify your area you need an architect certificate. Okay, based on the architect certificate the competent authority will be establishing what area the society is entitled for under deemed conveyance. Okay, so all the deemed conveyance application has to be prepared, the scrutiny has to be cleared, and with all the submitted documents and application will be put up before the competent authority of the respective jurisdictions where your buildings have been situated. In Mumbai we basically have 4 DDRs. So where the building is situated, there before that DDR we have to file an application. The day you file an application, within that period of 6 months the DDR has been directed to issue an order. So the proceedings which takes place are the summary proceedings. The question is, when you file an application, who are the person against whom you are going to file an application? So it's basically the application will be filed against the promoters. The party to the deemed conveyance application are basically the promoters. Now who are the promoters? Promoters are the landowners and the developers who have right in that particular land title. So when I say landowners means the person who has a title of that particular land. When I say a promoter means the person who has constructed the building. So these are the compulsory person to whom I am going to make a party to my deemed conveyance application. Along with that, while making an application I also need to check the land records, basically the 7 to 12 extract, the PR cards, whose names are appearing in the land records. So those persons also will be the party to the deemed conveyance application. So the DDR, after looking into the application, is going to issue a hearing notice, call upon the promoters and the landowners for a hearing, and opportunity of hearing will be given to both the parties. Here the submissions will be the written submissions as well as the oral submissions, but no cross examinations, no examination chief. So these are the summary proceedings. Then once the file is closed for order, it is reserved for order, within the period of 1 or 2 months you get a deemed conveyance certificate in your hand. So deemed convinced certificate means the competent authority is going to certify whether you are going to get a freehold title or a leasehold title. That is the first thing. Second thing, what area are you entitled for? When it's a single building, you are entitled to get the complete area of that land. But when it's a layout, in case of layout, what area are you supposed to get in proportion to the construction of your building? That is a biggest challenge. So that will be certified by the authority that this building XYZ is entitled for conveyance of freehold land for this much area. So this is a certificate which we get through an authority. Now this is an order. Now we need to get an implementation of this order done. An execution has to be carried out. So under the provisions of MOFA, this authority itself has been given the powers to execute its own order. So that is why implementation is also done by the same authority. So the second step which I'll tell is, the society has to prepare a deed of conveyance, because even though you get an order, you need a title document for your particular land and building. So deed of conveyance has to be drafted. Once you draft a deed of conveyance, before registration, the stamp duty has to be paid on that particular deed. Now in deemed conveyance, when we say the stamp duty has to be paid, the question is, what is the stamp duty applicable for deemed conveyance or on the title document of the land and building? In this particular case, authority, the cooperative department has come out with the circulars where it says that when we go for deemed conveyance, no separate duty has to be paid on the land if all the flat purchasers while purchasing their flat have paid the required stamp duty on their particular flats. So if all the flats, if suppose there are 20 flats in that particular building and all 20 flats have paid the appropriate stamp duty as per the Stamp Act, then when you go for the registration of that particular deed of conveyance, a stamp duty of rupees 100 only on per flat will be applicable as a respective stamp duty. But in case out of 20 there are only 15 flats who have paid the stamp duty and 5 flats have not paid the stamp duty, so those 5 flats have to pay the stamp duty at the time of adjudication of their respective deed of conveyance with a penalty of rupees of 400%. So that is called as adjudication process. The first process is deemed conveyance, getting a deemed conveyance order. The second process is adjudication of stamp duty, where you have to adjudicate whether there is any pendency of stamp duty to be done. For this, we make an application before the collector of stamp by submitting all the index to of all the documents. If suppose the documents are unregistered, you have to submit a copy of that agreement with an application. So the collector is going to certify that this is a deficit stamp duty which a society has to pay. So in that case, they also give you the bifurcation that against the respective flat, this is the amount. So the general body, the committee, has to collect that particular stamp duty against all the respective flats who are pending with that stamp duty. Once the stamp duty has been paid, we get a demand notice from the collector of stamp. So once you pay that stamp duty, then you get a clearance certificate, the document is adjudicated, and then we can move to the third process, and that is called registration of deed of conveyance. So we finished with the first process, we finished with the second process of adjudication. Here we are moving to the third process, and the third process is registration of deed of conveyance. So who is the authority here to register the deed of conveyance? The registration will be done by the sub-registrar itself. But the execution will be done by the DDR. DDR, by stepping into the shoes of the promoters, that is the landowners and developers, is going to execute the deed of conveyance, and the society will be executing the document in as a purchaser. So the vendors, the promoters, the execution will be done by the DDR, and in the capacity of purchaser, the execution will be done by the office bearers. So there you have to go, and that registration of deed of conveyance will take place. The registration will be done only when the stamp duty is clear, when you clear your adjudication stage and the registration fees is done. So this was the third step where the deed of conveyance gets registered. Now even after getting the deed of conveyance registered, the conveyance is not complete, because we are again left with a fourth process. The fourth process is getting the mutation entry recorded in the PR card. So in Mumbai, basically we have property cards. In main Mumbai, we have cadastral survey numbers, and after Bhayandar, we have 7-12 extracts. So whatever is your land record, in that particular land record, the mutation entry has to be carried out by the society, for which a society has to then make an application before city survey office. And then the city survey office, after looking through all the three processes, he is going to implement the fourth process and is going to record the name of the society as the holder, I mean the owner, or if it is a leasehold land, then as a lessee on the PR card. So the day the mutation entry is carried out, that day we can say the goal of conveyance of a society is completed.
Now let us come to CA Vijay Joshi. Sir, people have come here for professional opportunity. My and God. They want to see what is the opportunity in a cooperative housing society for the chartered accountant, what are the compliance required, when is the time and how the compliance can be done. So can you enlighten on the compliance and the professional opportunities?
Thank you, sir. A basic question for chartered accountant, chartered accountant profession. And for years together, chartered accountants have been looking at the practice, area of practice, as income tax and audit. That is the standard segment. And in the case of audit, we look at only cooperative society audit, right? However, cooperative society, including deemed conveyance and various other aspects under Cooperative Societies Act and all the related aspects, there is tremendous scope of practice. And all the stalwarts are here, so they would be better to speak. I would only highlight few things out of it. One is, of course, we start with the formation of society, which also can be carried out by chartered accountants. So it is not necessarily that only advocates can do it. Let me be candid and clear, right? So chartered accounts also can facilitate. And it would be a better role played, because chartered accountants are well aware of various transactions. Second aspect is, when you form a society, and we are aware under Cooperative Societies Act, there are so many records to be kept. So let us understand slightly in a detail, what is the cooperative society concept? Cooperative society concept is that cooperative society is a body that is registered of members. So members form themselves into the body, which means there has to be a separate entity. Now, if you look at, if you go to the any building, you don't see a society separately. It is the building, it is the flat owners. But there is a hypothetical, there is a existing, legally recognized body existing. Why I'm highlighting this aspect is, this highlights the necessity of keeping records appropriately. And these records are prescribed under the Act. There are various registers, shares, there are transfers, there are minutes, there are circulars, there are so many things. And all these records have to be kept in a manner in compliance with law, and they have to be followed up properly. And this is where the scope of practice becomes tremendous. We just now heard about the, I will take the small examples. We just now heard about the deemed conveyance registration, right? And there was one aspect of stamp duty adjudication. I'm taking one hypothetical example. Now, in the case of stamp duty adjudication, what happens is, there are 20 members out of which 15 have paid appropriate stamp duty, but 5 have not paid stamp duty. And society management, out of their I would say ignorance or more wiser knowledge, I would say, they have made a transfer of one flat without even looking at the appropriateness of the stamp duty paid. And this is happening. Now, this such member who has come secondly would object to payment of deficiency of stamp duty, because he is the transferee. He has transferred, and once the society has given the transfer, he is absolutely complete. Management has not seen the documents properly. They have not even waited with the advocate, with the some practitioner or some knowledgeable person. And therefore, the transfer has taken place and the dispute arose, and therefore these five people, maybe four or five, they are refusing to pay that additional stamp duty or difference of stamp duty, and therefore that entire process gets stuck. These are the practical difficulties that are happening in at each stage. It is not merely deemed conveyance, at every stage. Simple transfer of property, including gift. Nowadays, with the seniors, senior members, there's a practice or trend that is going on, that senior members are gifting their property into their to their sons, daughters, or whoever their dear ones. But that gift is not registered properly, or after registration is not recorded properly. Now, I have a case. I will highlight one small case, and then we will know what is the scope of chartered accountant. The property is held by husband and wife. Husband expires. and thereafter the legal heirs come into the place and they only execute release deed amongst each other and claim the entire property, that is 50% husband, 50% wife and they, and then they share release deed and they simply hand over that release deed to the society. No, society management is not aware of who is the legal heirs. What I'm saying is, I'm not going into the what is the answer. I don't want that answer. I'm saying chartered accountants can play a very great role only in documentation, verification, maintenance of records and guide them. Whether it should be recorded in the share register, whether it should be recorded in transfer register, who shall maintain this, how to maintain this. There is a tremendous scope of practice in simple minutes. Let me take a record of minutes. Minutes are to be maintained mandatorily by not only the general body but also by the managing committee. Managing committee minutes are so important. We are discussing about redevelopment process, and the redevelopment process, the entire onus is on the basis of recordings in the minutes. I'm sure there are cooperative courts and disputes which are actually, you know, being contested on the basis of these records. So proper drafting of minutes, proper recording of those facts and proper passing of resolution is necessary, where chartered accountants can play a great role. And let me tell you, it is only the statutory audit which is the prescribed fees is by the registrar, but all the other fees are open for chartered accountants. Therefore, depending we heard Prabhu sir, and he spoke of brand building. You can create a brand building only in this niche area of drafting documents, drafting minutes, drafting resolutions is so crucial that appropriately drafted resolutions would be the basis for fighting or claiming the right title. Therefore, minutes, managing committee, and let me tell you very clearly, very recently there is a circular registrar which said that every society managing committee, it is seen that managing committee minutes are not maintained. They are not recorded. That is a deficiency in the records. Therefore, chartered accountants have to ensure, auditors of course have to point out, that is auditor's duty, but chartered accountants have a scope of practice in doing this. And just as now, and let me tell you another aspect. Today, we find that many of these members in generally in all the societies are so busy in their day-to-day practice or day-to-day working that they hardly have any time to even look after the society maintenance, property maintenance and records maintenance. We have many of the buildings being maintained by hospitality service, and therefore hospitality agencies have come
okay,
up.
Okay.
I feel chartered accountants also can give such kind of combined service for such maintenance of records.
Okay. Just to conclude, he has said so many things. In nutshell, cooperative housing society or a cooperative society is a body corporate. It is registered under a separate act called either Maharashtra Cooperative Societies Act or under the Multi-State Cooperative Societies Act if the objectives are or the area of operation in two states. So registration is one. What type of business can be done? Another, preparing a business plan, giving them the required fund, giving them the process, procedure, documentation, and then complying with the various law, because cooperative societies, many are not aware, again is a business enterprise. If the cooperative is a business enterprise, whatever business which a society or rather a proprietor, partnership, limited company, private limited company, LLP can do, all this business can be done under the cooperatives. And therefore, the central government, union government, has set up a separate ministry under the leadership of Honorable Sri Amit Shah, giving 54 initiatives to empower the rural areas to promote economic activities under the cooperatives. You may not be aware, just to give you a figure, in Maharashtra, it's a government record, government figure, 59% of the economic activities in Maharashtra is carried under the cooperatives, 59%.
In the entire GDP of Maharashtra, 59% of the GDP is coming from cooperatives. If you divide cooperatives, private and public sector, cooperative is contributing 59%. Therefore, cooperative is for the members, of the members, by the members. And therefore, when the farm law, where central government wanted to do corporatization of the farming by giving the contract farming to various corporates where they can invest money, bring the what is known as infrastructure, get the capital there and make the life of the farmers easy, but because of certain communication gap, which again expressed by the Honorable Prime Minister, ki hum samjhane mein kamyab nahi ho paye, and therefore they had to withdraw. The central government thereafter thought it that we need to empower the farmers and empower India, and empowering India can happen only when you empower the rural. And therefore they took a point, plan B. The plan B is the cooperatives. And therefore the cooperatives ministry has been set up. Entire 8,16,000 cooperatives across India has been now computerized, and there is a national database, and he is going to do 2 lakh cooperatives which will be registered across India. In each village there will be one cooperative, multiple cooperative societies which will be empowered by the Ministry of Cooperations in the central government. The National Cooperative University has been set up. National Cooperative Export Multi-State Society has been set up. There is National Cooperative Development Corporation has been set up to give, and 22nd or 23rd July, when the budget comes, we will see that more than 1 lakh to 2 lakh crores, I'm giving you the figure, more than 1 lakh to 2 lakh crores are going to be invested through the NABARD to this cooperative sector. So there is an integration which has already happened. Integration of NABARD software with the state cooperatives across India, district cooperatives and the rural area multi-purpose cooperative societies. I would request you to go to this website, cooperation.gov.in. You will get the entire 54 initiatives, and I will tell you, if you really look at the two sectors which are empowering or which has got maximum GDP, one is agriculture through the cooperatives is going to be there, which as a chartered accountant we should be doing that, and the other one is the real estate, which is again highest contributor in cooperatives, rather GDP. If these two sectors, if you are able to master, which I have mastered, I think you can do wonders. You can make a difference in the life of the farmers in India and take this to the next level. We'll discuss more about other things. To say that as a business consultant, as a professional consultant, enough opportunities starting with registration, compliance, income tax, GST, redevelopment, documentation, and various labor laws, everything till the winding up, amalgamation and minutes writing, documentation, audit, internal control, internal system, all the professional opportunities that you see in a private sector is also open in the corporate sector. Thank you very much.